I think learning to watercolor is maybe like taking music lessons. Some people, like myself included, were driven to music lessons as a kid, and gradually some of it sunk in. But I wouldn't consider myself in those years a musician at all. And same is true of the painters. There are some here that I think have a lot of potential to go on in watercolor, and I hope they will. There are some that I don't think at this point will ever get it, but maybe they will if they keep plodding along like I did with my music. The classes we just had, first thing I taught was a review of what the materials were and what they can expect of them. As a beginner, they only had a single brush and a limited palette, that is a number of colors of paint that they could choose from. So using that single brush that they had, I showed them how to use it lightly to make a thin line or pressing down more to cover a wider area. And then we did some experiments with different techniques in watercolor, such as how to make a wash, that is a color, smooth color behind, and how to make tree shapes, and how to make grassy edges, and various techniques. We also started out by doing a simple painting. This is the first subject that they did, which is a just simple beach umbrella on the shoreline, and they did pretty good with that. This is the first time many of them ever had a brush in their hand at all. I did stress the fact to them that the paper is the most important thing of your brushes, your colors, and the paper. That the paper needs to be good quality, and I gave them all good quality Arches 140-pound watercolor paper to work on, even though they're just beginning, because you could paint a decent picture if you use good paper, even with amateur materials. But you can't use cheap paper and expect a good result, no matter how fine your brushes or colors are. Give it a chance. I told all these students here today and at the beginning a true thing about my own experience. I had painted since I was a kid in oils and acrylic, and I thought I'd give watercolor a shot, so I enrolled in a class of 6 or 8 weeks, and I hated it. First couple of weeks, I would have thrown it away and walked out, but I already paid for them, so I kept coming back. And lo and behold, after third or fourth week, something clicked. The light bulb went on, and suddenly I liked what I was doing, and I found that I had an open door in front of me. So for the future, I kept doing more and more watercolor to the point that that's almost exclusively what I do. Occasionally, I'll sneak in an acrylic. And I taught watercolor on cruise ships for a few years, which isn't really teaching. It's just babysitting whoever shows up for an hour or so on a cruise ship has nothing better to do. But as a matter of fact, some of the people that just came to kill a little time on the cruises actually turned out to like watercolor very much, and I still get emails from one of them that was on the first ship that I ever worked on. That was about 7 or 8 years ago, and she's in England, but she went home and started taking lessons and said, "You got me started," so I'm happy for that. So I'm hoping that some among these groups that come in here through the academy, there may be one or two that says, "This is for me, I'm gonna keep going." There's always classes going on. This one that I taught is just completed, but I know there's a lady coming in from outside of Shell Point that will be teaching also beginning watercolor, and I'm encouraging these people that were here to go on into that one, to get another teacher's viewpoint on beginning, because there's a wide spread of approaches to watercolor.